Hello friends, my name is Alissa and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum. And if you're like me, you might be getting a little tired of winter and looking for some new fun things to do. Well today, I'm going to show you how to make ice blocks. This is a great activity because you can go as crazy with it as you want. Here's what you'll need. Containers. Containers of all different sizes and shapes, and from your recycle box or maybe some storage containers that you have. You can use plastic bags. Anything that will hold water. And one thing to keep in mind is you don't want to use anything that's really important because sometimes the ice can crack a container. So definitely don't use glass and definitely don't use your favorite little plastic bin. If your containers have lids, great. But if they don't, you'll just want to cover it up with some plastic wrap and then hold that on tight with a rubber band. You can fill your containers with just water and put them in the freezer and leave it at that, or you can try putting some food coloring in there. You might also want to try putting some small toys or other small objects inside your containers, or go outside and collect some interesting looking leaves or other things from nature. Whatever you can think of, you can put it in your containers. Fill them up with water as much as you like. You don't have to fill it all the way to the top if you don't want to. And then put them in the freezer for a few hours or even overnight. Well, my ice blocks are frozen, and I got them out of the containers that I froze them in. That was a little challenging. I tried taking a spray bottle of warm water and spraying it around the outside of the containers to loosen up the ice. Then I whacked it on the ground a couple times and the ice came out. For the ones that were in the plastic bags, I just peeled the plastic bags away and now I have these really weird shapes. On this one, I don't know if you can really see it, but the ice broke as it was coming loose from the container. But now it looks like a little cave, and I could put a toy in there, or I could put a little electric candle like this one in there. That would look nice in the evenings. There's lots of ways you can play with your ice cubes. I'm going to give you just a few ideas, but I am sure that you will come up with tons more. One thing you can do is take some cold water and spray it on one of your ice blocks and then set the other one on top. And then wait a few minutes and see if they melt together, and then you've got a new shape. If you don't have a spray bottle for either one of these, you can just take a bowl of water and use a paintbrush to paint the water onto your ice blocks. I also tried playing around with salt. If you've tried any of our ice experiments before, you know that salt can have an effect on ice. So that was fun to explore. Managed to stick a couple of my ice blocks together here, and they've got a really cool design in them from the salt. There's lots of ways that you can play around with your ice blocks. And since it's still winter, it's always a good idea to have more things that you can try. And if you're in New England, then maybe you know that we never really know when winter's going to end. So the more things you can do to get outside, and the more new things you have to try, the better. Thanks for joining me today. And if you liked this video, don't forget to follow us on social media and subscribe to us on YouTube. Just click the big red button. See you next time.